Thank you, Ian. You paid attention to some fundamental issues, sometimes on a very ironic way, but that's your style, I know that. But now we are continuing with the next speaker, Natalie Plum. Natalie is working with the IKSR, I think that's a commission for the Rhine. You will explain it later. You are a geographer and a biologist, and you've been working there for a couple of years now, and before that you were working in an Interreg project all about river restoration. So I'd like to give you the floor and tell us something about your experience in the Rhine Commission, yes?
You know how this works?
Forward.
The pointer is the green one.
Pointer, okay. Thank you. As I have to go very close to it, I think. Yes. Okay, thanks. As you can see from the design of my sheets, I'm not part of the reform project. So the ICPR is an international commission founded in the 1950s, so no one would dream about the Water Framework Directive then. But we already made a lot of work in this direction, and we continue with the directive today. So we have the states with a bigger part in the Rhine catchment. These are France, Germany, the Netherlands, and Switzerland as a non-EU member. It's not an EU member country, so that's something special about our work. Also, Liechtenstein is not a member, and we have other smaller member states, like even Italy, Austria, the Wallonian region, and Luxembourg on the biggest tributary, the Mosel, and those in italics are observers. So our secretariat is based in Koblenz. It's in the middle of the catchment, more or less. And as you see, the catchment is intensively used, not only in the Netherlands, and it's also densely settled. You have navigation. Drinking water has to be supplied for 30 million people, and there's a lot of industry on the banks, especially chemical plants, oil plants, and also energy production also in the river. In the upper Rhine, there are some big hydroelectric plants, and chemical industry is a special topic in the ICPR because it once accelerated things, the whole work. So the foundation was in 1950, but was only in 1986 when things went quicker. There was a big accident in Switzerland, you all know about, and when with the fire in this chemical plant, tons of pesticides went to the Rhine with the extinction water. All life in the water downstream was killed, and it took the Rhine ministers less than 2 weeks to decide that the action program Rhine had to save the ecosystem that was destroyed at this moment. So this run until the year 2000, and the drinking water should be guaranteed, contamination should be reduced, so wastewater treatment plants should be built, and 60 priority substances were determined, and retention basins for fire extinction water were built, so this kind of accident could not happen again. And a warning and alert plan was set up. So as Ian told us, we did the right thing. We improved water quality first before the other ecological targets were begun. So here the chemical monitoring program shows that all the contamination went down, and then the Rhine recovered from a sewer into a living river, And this picture is showing the rainfall at Schaffhausen, and this is a natural limit for the distribution of Atlantic salmon that plays a special role at the Rhine Commission. He cannot go up this fall, so upstream we have another fish I will talk about later. So you also have to cope with the natural conditions we heard about today from Angela, I think. Huh? So this is a picture showing how the oxygen content went down in the 1960s, 1970s in the Rhine. This is the oxygen content, and the species, the invertebrate species also, the species number went down, but it recovered considerably when oxygen content went up again. Now we have about 560 taxa in the Rhine again. Okay, this was to show the same thing. Now about the salmon. Some people said that it would be an impossible target to reintroduce this vanished species, but other people said choose it as a symbol for other migratory fish and for the whole ecosystem, saying when the salmon is thriving well, the whole ecosystem is healthy. There are other migratory fish species we are also dealing with. The sea trout, Ellis shad, suede shad, Houting, sea lamprey and river lamprey are back, and also the eel was always there, has always been there, but the common sturgeon is missing. But now there's a project in Netherlands I heard about, so it's perhaps even the sturgeon is coming back. Then you have to know about salmon that it's born in the tributaries, but then it goes to the sea to feed, and then the adults come back to their spawning, to their home tributaries to spawn. And therefore, that's a special thing about salmon, because most problems we are dealing with in the ICPR, about upstream, downstream principle of solidarity. So it's about water quality. People upstream are responsible for what they put into the water. It goes downstream, and people downstream have the problem with it. The same is true for flood. Now, for salmon, it's the other way around, because they are coming from the North Sea, and now the Netherlands have to let the salmon pass by. And so we are hoping that the Haringvliet sluices will really be opened in 2018. And also the ASL Afsluit Dijk will be equipped with fish passes. So all the work that I will show you now that is done further upstream in the other Rhine bordering countries is worthwhile. So these are the registrations of salmon since the 1990, when the first salmon stocking was done. You see that in the lower Rhine, or in a tributary of the lower Rhine, there are the highest numbers. This is the historical distribution, and as you can see, the Afsluit Dijk didn't exist, Haringvliet didn't exist, and most of the dams we find now in the tributaries didn't exist, so no problem for salmon to go almost everywhere. And here you see the other fish I was talking about, this Lake Constance lake trout. It has his distribution up the Rhine fall in the Alpine region. So feeding in the lake, in Lake Constance, and then going to the tributaries to spawn. So in 2007, there was a Rhine Ministers Conference. So the Rhine ministers, these are most of them are environmental ministers. They are coming together not in regular periods, but sometimes when there are special problems to discuss about and take decisions about. And in 2007, it was about to restore the continuity stepwise in the Rhine mainstream up to Basel and the program tributaries for salmon. And the ICBR had the task to identify spawning and juvenile habitats to revitalize them and make them accessible. And the impossible goal to build up self-sustaining salmon stocks. So yes, this is jumping salmon in the River Sieg. Okay. So we began with a broad study about the effectiveness of measures. And you see here, the bigger the sign, the more measures have to be taken, or the higher priority this measure has. So in the Netherlands here, this is Haringvliet again. It's about river continuity. But these are fishing has to be limited also here and here at the entrance of the bigger tributaries. But also there are also other pressures like predation and habitat measures to be taken, the green ones. And based on this study, we set up our master plan Migratory Fish Rhine. You will find all the reports on our internet site. I will show the address later. And the green river stretches are locally passable. So if the salmon once has passed the Delta Rhine, it can go up until Strasbourg now, but construction of a fish pass there is going on already, and the next one for Gerstheim the work will begin in 2 years' time, and then we will see. Also on the Mosel, work is going on, big fish passes. So I think the next map we will make will have more green stretches already. Since 2000, 481 barrages have been rebuilt or equipped with fish passes, or completely broken down in the smaller tributaries. It's possible here and there. So about the eel, I won't talk too much. It's the other way around, you know. He's traveling downstream and through the sea to spawn in the Sargasso Sea, and then he comes back as a small glass eel. I also made a map about it. A lot of habitat for the eel, but we have problems with downstream migration, also parasites and the old pollutants remaining in the Rhine, most of all in the sediments. So now a new target for the ICPR is really to improve downstream migration, not only for eel, and to look at the best techniques to do it. It's not so easy, especially for the big dams and big hydropower plants. Also very important for small salmon traveling to the sea. Yeah, more about stocking of salmon. It's a new map we made in a report about the success of the master plan until now. You see that we have different coordination units to do the stocking. In the Delta Rhine, no stocking is done. There are no spawning habitats, logical, but then in the Lower Rhine, and then here the Middle Rhine countries are using the same salmon, and here the France and Baden-Württemberg, so in southern Germany and also Switzerland, are using another salmon. Another origin. It's the same species, but another origin. And then we have here the Lake Constance lake trout in the Alpine region. There's also stocking is done. And here you see the natural reproduction. The bigger the fish, the more natural reproduction is already taking place. And that's our hope, that this will go on in this direction. And then one day we have a self-sustaining population. And some impressions from breeding and stocking, young fish, eggs. And another map showing the breeding stations, the small houses here, and the monitoring stations. Some of them equipped with video, so not only salmon, but all fish coming along are counted. And a lot of good data we have from there. So the spawning habitats, there's a big potential, more than 1,000 hectares in the whole basin and all program waters. And newly discovered an extra 200 hectares in River Aare in Switzerland. But in 2012, only about 260, I think, were accessible. So a lot to do, and the future challenges are go in this direction to restore the river continuity in the Rhine mainstream. So not only Haringvliet, but also in the Upper Rhine, the big hydropower plants there to equip them with fish passes, and also in the big tributaries. And then improve the downstream migration to prevent that fish are injured, like shown on this sad picture. So that's where we also are busy with the implementation of the Water Framework Directive. Orange is heavily modified water bodies. There are a lot in our water net, as you see. Water-related habitats, Natura 2000 and habitats along the BERT directive, these all the water-related are shown here, and we have to find synergy with other projects going on in the ICPR. That's an old project. It comes from the Action Program Rhine, and we just went on with these targets that the. The floodplain should be reconnected and reactivated. And you know that the target could be reached. It's not impossible. The target is about to reactivate 160 square kilometers of floodplain, and we have already 122. That's also a target we should connect with the flood directive. There are also a lot of synergy effects, and the ICPR is also busy with flood prevention. So there we have to meet the other people, just as Ian says. The same is true for the alluvial waters. Already 80 water bodies have been reconnected in the Rhine between 2000 and 2012, and the target is about 100. So this will be reached, I'm nearly sure. It's a bit different with the riverbanks. As you saw in the beginning of the presentation, the Rhine is densely settled, intensively used. There's industry, settlements, also railroads, traffic roads, and so on, along wide stretches of the river. So it's really, really hard to find places to increase structural diversity of the riverbanks. Here's an example from the Middle Rhine. It looks nice already, but the target of 800 kilometers is ambitious. Nevertheless, the Rhine ministers that gathered this year in October 2013, they want to keep on this goal. That's a nice project the ICPR started in 2004. There's a publication from 2006 about the habitat patch network along the Rhine with a big atlas. I couldn't bring, it's just too big, but we have it on the internet, so you can download it. With a lot of with very detailed maps about showing places where biotope network is good already, but also deficitary areas in red, like in the big cities. And we are just doing a success control that's going on. So in the future challenges are in the for the chemical group to reduce the diffuse emissions further. It's about nutrients, but also pesticides, how to cope with micropollutants coming from pills, detergents, and so on, also pesticides. And then to improve habitats and to stabilize them against climate change effects. And I hope this will be taken into the strategy of the ICPR facing climate change, that we improve habitats and then improve the resilience of them against climate change. So, that was my motto in the beginning. Ah, there's a picture. A last sentence about our way of work. You see, we have a lot of reunions in our languages, German, French, and Dutch. But English is spoken most of all at this kind of site events, like this one 2000 on the plenary assembly in Schaffhausen, because people also have to meet each other, they have to know each other. And the special thing about the Rhine Commission is that there's a climate of transparency and trust. And that's what makes the work efficient and also fun. So, thank you a lot. This is the internet.